So good afternoon to everyone. So in last class we have seen about the syllabus. In first class and in second class we have seen about the basic concepts of electricity, capacitance, magnetism, resistance, voltage, and various pressure concepts, like what is Gauss pressure, what is absolute pressure, what is vacuum. These concepts are necessary to understand the basic instrument and instrumentation which we are going to study. Okay, so in today's class we will see the basic concepts in the instrumentation. Okay, so what is measurement, what is variable, what is set point, okay, how it works, what are different kinds of properties of the instrument, what is sensor, what is transducer. So these all things we will learn in this, try to learn in this, in today's class. Okay, so let's begin. So we know that as we have discussed, the dairy industry is a multi-product industry, and it involves several unit operations like mixing, blending, heating, cooling, freezing. There are different kinds of unit operations carried out simultaneously in dairy industry. Okay, and these unit operations are carried out under various conditions, like at different temperatures, different pressures. Okay, some operations carried out in vacuum, some operations carried out at high pressure, steam is at high pressure. Okay, so there are different physical, chemical conditions needed while processing of dairy products, different flows, there are different physical compositions and temperature variations too. Okay, so the measurement and control of these variable factors at various stages of processing requires accurate and efficient instrument. Okay, in addition to the dependence upon human skills. So when we are going for a mass production in big dairies, there is a mass production. Okay, this mass production requires a perfect human skill as well as a perfect instrumentation, a perfect process control also. We cannot solely depend upon a human skills also. It requires an instrumentation, a better technological intervention. Okay, and this technological intervention should be accurate through a medium called instruments, okay, efficient instruments. So this measurement and control of the different variables, like variables, what is in the variables we learn in next slide. Okay, so there are different kind of variables. Flow, temperature, pH, acidity, these are different variables. Okay, so these all requires accurate and efficient instruments. So with the advent of large scale milk handling plants, the automatic operation and control through efficient instrumentation and automation has become even more necessary. We know that India is the largest milk producer in the world, and tons of milks process every day in big dairies, and the dairies are handled by big companies, and that companies required a sophisticated instrumentation, sophisticated technology to process that much of large quantity of milk. Okay, you have to be competitive, at the same time you have to keep the, you have to give the quality, you have to improve the quality, and also you have to minimize the cost of production. So instrumentation and automation curtail down your production cost. And utilities such as steam, water, electricity, okay, have to be measured and controlled at appropriate points in the plant. You know, this utility cost is a significant cost in a dairy processing plant or production of the any product, because all this requires some kind of electricity or fuel, and you know the cost of the fuels is rising day by day. Okay, so you have to use the utilities in a very efficient way. Okay, so with that perspective, we have to maintain, we have to observe them, the proper use of these utilities team. Anything which is used over and above, okay, is lost to the company. Okay, so we need to avoid that. We should avoid that, and so as to be a competitive in the market. Automation control instruments are employed to measure and control the temperature, pressure, flow and levels of these utilities. So automatic control, what automatic controls do? They measure and control these different variables like temperature, pressure, flow. You don't need to put a person, okay, at every instrument to check whether it is coming up or down. Okay, these automatic instruments controls the things automatically. You don't need a manual intervention. Now if there is no instrumentation, consider a case if there would be no instruments. In that case, you would have to keep one person at a temperature to check the temperature of a milk. He will check manually, and when the temperature reaches a certain point, he will stop the flow of milk by closing the valves. Okay, so in that case, you have to increase your number of persons in the industry, okay, in a plant. So this, but after automation, these things totally change. The things, the instruments, the automation makes it easier for a company to observe everything 24/7. Okay, so these things, only a person on a single screen is sufficient to monitor everything in a plant. So this is the significance of automation. Okay, so the overall aim of the instrumentation automation is to improve the product quality and enhance the plant efficiency for a better economic returns. So as we know that to human is the heir. Okay, human, there will be errors if there is a human. Okay, so but in case of instruments or technology, it is not happened. Okay, they don't complain. Okay, they don't need holidays. It works 24/7. Okay, so with this we can improve our quality too, because a quality, if we intervene or if we employ a person, the quality of the product may be changed person to person. Okay, someone keeps the pH 5.6, someone keep the 5.5, someone add 2 glass of sugar, someone add 1 glass of sugar. Like it will change, vary with the person to person. Okay, if you visit some different shops in the market, herbal shops, and you purchase a peda, you will find some quality difference between each of the herbal shop. But when you employ instrumentation or process control or automations, you will get the same result. You will get the same kind of product, irrespective of batch, time, when it is prepared. Okay, so these are some advantages of the instrumentation and process control. By employing both these, you will have a better quality, and your economic returns will be improved. So now let's understand the basic terms, basic important terms in instrumentation and process control. The very first is the variable. Okay, so what is my variable? As it sounds, variable means something that is vary. Vary means it gets changed over a time. That is called a variable. So which is changing with time is called as variable. Okay, so it is basically characteristics, number or a quantity that increase or decrease over time or takes different values in different situation is known as variable. So any quantity or a number, any physical quantity, say like pH or temperature, you know that temperature may change with respect to time. Okay, at 3 o'clock it will be 60 degrees centigrade, at 4 o'clock it may be 62, it goes down to 63, like this it will happen. Okay, so this is, so these things are changing in pasteurizer. What happens, the pasteurization temperature changes with time, so accordingly the sensors sense the temperature and they increase or decrease the steam flow rate, okay, or the water flow rate, so as to get the desired set point temperature, like 72 or 75 plus minus 3 degrees centigrade. So this is the variable. Temperature is a variable quantity. Okay, a variable means which decrease or increase over a time. Your speed is a variable. Okay, if you are to go on a bike, your speed may be increase or decrease over a time. It is not a constant thing. Okay. So variable is basically a quantity that increases or decreases over time. So it is a factor that can be assigned a measurable dimensions of subcurrent. That, for example, length, diameter, area, flow, weight, cost, or lifespan, etc. So you know that in our case, pH will be a variable, temperature will be a variable, then flow rate will be a variable. So a dependent variable is any measurable factor whose behavior is controlled by another variable. Okay, so there are two type of variables. One is a dependent variable, another is a independent variable. Okay, a dependent variable means, suppose in case of pasteurizers, okay, temperature changes according to change in the temperature of heating water. Okay, temperature of milk changing according to the temperature of heating medium. Okay, so temperature of milk is the dependent variable because it depends on something. That heating medium temperature or its flow rate changing the temperature of milk. So a dependent variable is any measurable factor whose behavior is controlled by another variable. Okay, so this another variable is the steam flow rate or a heating medium temperature, that is called as a dependent variable. Okay, an independent variable is any measurable factor that produces change or reaction in another variable. So in the first case, milk temperature is dependent variable, while in second case, steam flow rate or heating medium is independent variable. Okay, so there are two kind of variables, dependent variables and independent variables. So variable is something that is changed or altered in an experiment. Okay, in processing of food products, the variables involved could be temperature and pressure of steam, as I earlier said. Okay, processing time, flow rate, flow rate of milk, like that, processing time, flow rate of milk, flow rate of water, flow rate of steam, etc. For example, to determine the effect of temperature and humidity on storage of food product will provide evidence on the shelf life of product in different storage conditions. This is the example of variables. Variable is liable to change, may have a range of possible values, and is liable to deviate from an established extension. Right. As I have said, variable is subject to change. We have set a point like pasteurization at 75 degrees centigrade, okay, plus minus 3. So it may go up to the 78 or it may go up to the 72 degrees centigrade, 75 plus minus 3. So variable liable to change. It will go up to 78, it will come down up to 72. Okay, it will deviate from the set point. So what is the function of our controllers then? To keep the milk temperature between 72 to the 78 degree centigrade, but to keep as close as to the 75.
Okay,
this is the variable. The next one is the what is measurement. So there is a power in a lean manufacturing or a process or operational excellence. Okay, in operational excellence or in a lean manufacturing, there is a proverb: if you can measure, you can improve. Means anything, if you can measure, you can improve it by having some data. If you don't have any data, you cannot improve anything. For improvement, you must need something, some raw data or something or any information you should have. Okay. Without that, you cannot say you won't come to know that what is increasing, what is decreasing. So for that purpose, we have to measure first. If you don't measure, how will you come to know that something is increasing, something is decreasing, something is constant? And so very basic is you have to measure. So measurement is the basic thing in instrumentation. So the measurement is usually undertaken to ascertain and present the state, condition or characteristics of a system in quantitative terms. In quantitative terms, quantitative means 1, 2, 3, which can be measured. So it is generally used to ascertain the present state, okay, or a condition or a characteristics. I am measuring the temperature, it means what? I am measuring the degree of hotness at that particular instant. It will give me some kind of data at 2 o'clock this must be temperature, at 2 point after 1 minute this will be like that, after 3 minute it was here. So measurement gives us some kind of data or surety or ascertain condition or characteristics of a system in quantitative terms. In quantitative terms, okay. In quantitative means 72 degrees centigrade, 73 degrees centigrade, 74 degrees centigrade. It won't give like that hotter, hottest, hot. No, not like that. It gives in terms of quantitative. Okay, sweet, sweeter, sweeted. This is the qualitative term. But 72, 73, 74, 75 is a quantitative term. So instruments gives the information in quantitative forms. It enables the experimenter to understand the state of the system under which it exists or to distinguish the transition of the system from one state to another. So if there is any deviation, it gives them idea about what is happening. Is there any deviation? What is the condition of present system? Milk is being pasteurized, okay. Pasteurization is happening or not. It gives some, how will come to know from pasteurizing milk is pasteurized or not? By looking the temperature data over a time. Okay. And how we will confirm, ascertain the efficiency of pasteurization? That is the alkaline phosphatase test. Alkaline phosphatase test is the qualitative terms. Okay. That is the another thing. To reveal the performance of a physical or chemical system, the first operation carried out on it is measurement. So if we want to know the performance of the system or any physical or chemical system, we have to first measure the things. If you don't measure the money you have, you can't say, see, I have this much money. You will say I have money, but if you don't measure, you can't say I have 1 crore, I have 2 crore, I have 3 crore. So first we have to measure the things. To measure is to determine the magnitude, extent, degree, etc. of the condition of the system in terms of standard. Standard means in kg, like kg per meter cube, liters, pH and acidity in terms of lactic percent lactic acid. Okay, volume by volume, weight by volume. This in terms of standard units. Okay. So measurement is the basic primary operation, the result of which is used only to describe the system and hence treated as an independent operation with no ulterior motive other than to understand. So measurement is a independent operation. Okay. And its basic and primary option is to describe the state of the system, whether it is changing or not, or is a constant, anything. Okay. So when we decide to study a variable, we need to devise some way to measure it. So suppose I want to measure a liquid in a tank. Okay. We need to first analyze what to measure, how to measure. Okay. So when we decide to study a variable, we need to devise some way to measure. Okay. If you can't measure, you can't come to know what is changing, what is variable. That is the measurement. So some variables are easy to measure and others are very difficult. What are the easy variables to measure, like your liquid level, weight, okay, the pH is also easy, acidity is also easy, density is also easy, but some variables may be difficult. Okay. So based upon the type of variables, we need to employ that kind of instrument there, or any measuring instrument there. The values of variables are made meaningful by quantifying them into specific units. So for example, instead of saying that a particular fluid is hot, we can specify a measurement and specify that the fluid is having a temperature of 80 degrees centigrade. Okay. So this is the measurement. So measurement gives us some data or indication, or it gives a quantity. Yeah, this is the temperature. Someone will say it is hot. You don't understand hot means how much. Okay. For some person, for a child, even a 50 degree centigrade will be a hot, but for a adult, it will be a lukewarm. Okay. But when you will measure it by some kind of thermometer, you can exactly take, yeah, this is the 50 degree centigrade, this is the 60 degree centigrade, this is the 70 degree centigrade, this is the 80 degree centigrade, this is much hotter. So this information gives values of variables are made meaningful by quantifying them into specific units. So measurement is collection of quantitative data. A measurement is a collection of quantitative data. Okay, it is not a qualitative data, it is a quantitative data. A measurement is made by comparing a quantity with a standard unit. Standard unit means like degree centigrade, your weight in kg or psi, any standard unit. Okay. An example of measurement means to use the ruler, use of ruler to determine the length of piece of a paper. This is the example of measurement. So measurement is essentially an act of result of comparison between two quantity and predefined standard. Okay. So measurement is basically what is? It is a comparison of between the quantity. Quantity means same quantity. If temperature is a quantity, means we are measuring temperature. So the comparison between temperatures. Now it is 70. After some time, it will be 75. It is the comparison. Okay. So it is basically a comparison. What was previous temperature? What is now? And what will be after some time? That is the comparison. Since both the quantities are compared, the result is expressed in numerical values. You cannot compare temperature with weight. Okay, you cannot compare temperature with weight. It must be a same thing. Weight can be compared with weight. Weight cannot compare with a temperature. Okay, so it is expressed in really numerical values. In the physical sciences, quality assurance and engineering measurement is the activity of obtaining and comparing physical quantities of real world objects and. So in our engineering or in a dairy plant, we measure real things, okay, real world objects like temperature, pressure, level, here chastity like this, that percentage. Established standard objects and events are used as units, and the process of measurement gives the number of the item under study and the reference unit of the measurement. Okay. There are two essential requirements of the measurements in order to make the result meaningful. So basically, there are two things which are essential for the measurements, which imparts characteristics to the measurements, which makes it results meaningful. First one is the standard used for comparison purpose must be accurately defined and should be commonly accepted. What is meant by this? What is meant by that? If you are measuring a temperature, you should measure it in a commonly accepted terms. So we know that we are engineering student, and the commonly accepted terms for engineering, the units of temperature are like degree centigrade, okay, degree Kelvin or Kelvin, Rankine. There are 3-4 units for the temperature which are universally accepted, like SI units, okay, CGS units, MKS units. These are the universally accepted units. Okay. If you come with your own kind of units, it is not going to work. Okay. If someone come with your name, degree Rupesh, like this, so next person will not understand what is 1 degree Rupesh, what is 2 degree Rupesh. No. It should be of universally accepted terms. Okay. It must be of universally accepted for the comparison purpose. Standard used for comparison purpose must have accurately defined, because these universally accepted things are like I said, they are having a concrete definition. Okay, they are accurately defined. 1 degree centigrade is equal to this, specific heat is equal to this, 1 kg equal to this, they have standard definitions. And next one is the apparatus used and the method adopted must be provable. Okay, so whatever the method and apparatus you are using, that must be provable. It means it should not be like that you perform some experiment in your home and you told that to the world that I have performed this experiment. So you have performed experiment in your home, but you have to prove in front of the people also. It should be repeatable. Okay, whatever you perform in your home should be replicated in the other, at other place or other area also, or anyone can do this. Okay, should be able to do that. So the apparatus used and the method adopted must be provable. These are the two basic things for measurement, essential requirements. So in the development of measurement, what is the development of measurement system, how it gets developed, how it is important? So man extends his skills to identify physical phenomena. So we know that necessity is the mother of invention. Okay, so persons or human explore different fields, they dig out different phenomena, principle, concepts, they worked out day and day in, okay, day in day out, and they come up with different discoveries, inventions. Okay, so develop and utilize the means for confirmation of his understanding of the phenomena. Measuring techniques and systems developed are based on the basic laws of nature and evolution of these techniques. So generally, this measurement system is basic, based upon the basic laws of nature, like what is gravity is also kind of law of nature. Okay, so weight, we know that how we measure the weight, what is the when we stand on some weighing balance, it multiply our mass into acceleration due to gravity, or into gravity multiplied by it will gives you your exact weight, or weight changes according to the planet. So on moon our weight will be different, on Neptune our weight will be different, but mass will be the same. So it involves the basic laws of nature. Development of indicating systems for some of the physical quantities. So in the event of this necessities and exploring the different phenomena, scientists develop some indicating devices which gives us the real time data. Indicating system means a pressure measurement, like a speedometer on your bike or vehicle. Okay, that is an indicating device. Indicates some data. Okay, interaction with quantity under measurement and develop output signals in the form of linear or angular displacement that can be transmitted to a point on a scale. So if you see a pressure gauge, there is a pointer. Okay, whatever pressure you apply on the pressure downside of the pressure gauge, that needle will displace accordingly. Okay, that is called a displacement. So by changing the pressure into a displacement scale, something is displacing. Okay, so we are converting from one form to the another, and that will give us the some kind of interaction and some kind of output signals. So this is the, so how this measurement system evolved. So what are the basic stages of measuring systems? So very first is the primary element that senses the quantity under measurement. So there is one primary element, there is one intermediate elements, and there is one end device. So primary element is which senses the quantity under measurement. So in case of pasteurization, we are measuring temperature. Our primary element is a temperature sensing device, a thermometer. Okay, thermometer, the tip of the thermometer is the primary sensing element in case of if we are measuring a temperature. So that is called a primary sensing element that measures the quantity under measurement. We are measuring temperature, we are employing thermometer is the primary sensing element. Okay, the next one is the intermediate, means that modifies suitably the output of the primary element. Okay, so whatever primary sensor senses the degree of hotness or coldness in case of temperature measurement, the intermediate device, okay, modifies that signals or takes the signal from the primary sensing element and modify it and send to the final element or final device. Okay, suppose in case of RTD will sense the tip of the resistant temperature detector. It will sense the temperature. That temperature will amplify by an intermediate device, and it will send to the some kind of indicating device or signal. Okay, by which we will come to know what is the temperature of at that particular point. So intermediate device modifies the input signal to the output signal, or send it to the some kind of indicating device. Okay, the end device that renders the indication possibly on a calibrated scale. So the end device means, suppose if a pressure gauge is there, so that scale and that needle will be your end device. Okay, so there will be some kind of displacement, and according to displacement that needle will deflect from zero position to some one position, two position, three, like that. So that will be your end device. So it is possibly a calibrated scale. Okay, so these are the basic stages of measuring systems. Some examples of basic indexing system line: the biometric thermometer, the boredom to pressure gauge, okay, and permanent magnet moving coil ammeter. These are the example of basic indicating systems. And a meter means a combination of certain basic elements, measures a physical quantity and provides an output signal in the form of mechanical displacement. So as I said, in pressure gauge, okay, or your weighing balance is also a meter. You stand on weighing balance, and that needle shows your weight. It deflects to and fro. Okay, so there are some springs and load cells, so accordingly that it will displace and it will give you the exact weight of your own body. So there is a meter. It has some calibrated scale. It can be a system that converts a physical quantity under measurement into a displacement signal. So deflection of a pointer or a needle is kind of a displacement measurement. So for today's, so we will see this much only for today's class. So in next class, we'll discuss about different kinds of measurement. Okay, thank you.